Light is a really unique medium to work with.
It's this non-physical thing.
You can't see where you've drawn. It's not tangible. It's just kind of like you project it out there, and hopefully you end up with something good. I think it helps me a lot in doing these light drawings to think of the light source as a pen and the camera as a piece of paper.
These have always been more drawing than photo for me. The camera is just a way to record the drawing.
My girlfriend Taylor helps me out a lot with these drawings, and so she's going to be here tonight. We're out at Cedar Lake. We'll be kind of working with what's here. We're looking at a perfect night. There's no clouds, sun setting, not many people out here, so it's a good setup.
Yeah, I think that'll be awesome.
This mystery rock comes rolling into the frame.
The light drawings I make have no, like, kind of manipulation or anything like that. It's all done through the normal, standard photographic process. There's no Photoshop used. There's no other kind of weird post-processing tricks to use. Dragging these lights around these objects and these people in these spaces is like making a handmade, hyper-intentional photograph. So whereas some people might, you know, capture their memories by clicking a shutter, and then there it is.
Yeah, can you just hold it there? Because I'm going to adjust the frame a little bit.
I'm going with more of the reductive aspect, and so when we open the shutter, the only thing that's going to be recorded is what we intend to do. It's really finicky, the same way that maybe you'd be drawing with a pen on paper, and if it's a really inky pen, you stop on one spot, the ink will just bleed out. It's like that times 10 with light.
Ideally, you're doing your drawings in complete darkness. You can't see the environment you're drawing in. You can't see the edges of the frame, so you have to kind of do a lot of planning and get that all kind of figured out ahead of time and then keep it locked in, concentrate, focus.
This all started back in late 2005, so I'd graduated from college, and I'd just gotten my first DSLR, and so I was like, oh, I'm gonna try and write my name with my cell phone. And so set it up, and opened the shutter, and wrote my name, then closed the shutter, and looked at it. I'm like, oh, that's so cool. And then I'm like, I'm gonna try and draw a face with my phone now. You know, you can look at that and it's pretty obvious. It's like, oh yeah, it's a crappy drawing of a face. But to me, it was just like, ding, you can do drawings with a camera. So I like the composite light drawings a little more than the single shot light drawings because they have a little more freedom to create things that maybe aren't there. Since we start with source photography, we can really draw anything we want to. So for instance, you want to do a drawing of some hands. So we'll take some photos of some hands, chop it up into its individual pieces, and take each one of those, print it out as a 12 by 18, and we'll take all those 12 by 18s and lay them out on the ground, do this massive composite, and do marker notes on them to kind of flesh out more detail where, you know, certain lines need to be made, color notes for different colors of light that we're going to be using. And then we'll stack those all up and we're ready to shoot. So when we shoot, I sit at one end of a low table and the camera's on the other end of the table. And between us is this piece of cardboard with a window cut out of it, the same size as the 12 by 18 printouts that are sitting next to me. And I'll look at the first reference print, and I'll memorize all the lines and the forms and the shapes in it. And then I'll turn all the lights off, open the shutter, and draw in that cardboard mat what I remember seeing on that reference print. And after I'm done drawing everything that I remember, then I close the shutter, turn on the little light, look at the next reference print, and just repeat that process until they're all done. I really feel like this is an area of photography that hasn't had nearly enough exploration, where we're kind of looking at a camera in a completely different way. Not as this instrument to just click, 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 capture, 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 but where we're actually using the camera to make drawings. And I don't think we've even come close to like realizing all the possibilities. And I'm just trying to chip in on that exploration.